All right, brothers, sisters, friends, good to see everybody.
弟兄姐妹，朋友们，大家好，高兴见到大家。
And I'm happy to be back in with the church.
好，很高兴回到教会来。
Patrice is not here today because her sister actually is coming to town early tomorrow morning.
啊，Patrice今天没有在这边，因为她的姐姐明天一早上啊就会飞到新加坡来。
Okay, so she's preparing the house and getting everything ready.
她在打理着那个屋子，然后为她的探访做准备。
So Sunday she also will not be here. Most probably will not be here. Okay, I'll be here. Amen.
然后星期天呢，她很大的可能性也会不在啊。不过我会在这边。
She will bring her sister to the Singapore church.
然后她会带她姐姐去新加坡教会。
Okay, so last weekend, if you did not know, Patrice and I, we were with the Bangkok church. We had a retreat.
然后上个周末呢，我们一个退休会，然后我们在曼谷。
Okay, so this is the picture of our retreat.
然后这是我们退休会的那一个照片。
Amen. Okay, and this is the picture of the leader of the Bangkok church and his brother.
然后这个是曼谷教会的那一个领导，还有他的brother,
older brother.
他的哥哥。
Sokun and Kenneth.
Sokun and Kenneth.
Again, they are both working full time, but they are both also, he's leading the church as well.
然后他们两个呢是有全职的工作，然后同时他们也一起的带领这个曼谷教会。
Okay, and here's the leaders of the youth ministry.
然后这个呢就是青少年组的那一个领导。
Okay, it's Boon Song and Tall.
Boon Song and Tall.
Mighty Tall.
Mason.
Before there was Tall, there was Tall.
还没有Mason就有这位姐妹Tall。
Okay, so the place that we went to is very beautiful. It's up in the mountains, in Bangkok, 3 hours outside of Bangkok.
然后我们去的地方呢？ 很美丽，很漂亮。它是离曼谷3个小时车程的一个高原地区。
So it's the place is called Khao Yai.
那地方叫Khao Yai.
Okay, so it's another place that a lot of Thai people would go for holiday. It's not so popular with the outside tourists, but the local people.
然后是一个泰国本地人的那一个旅游名胜地。
It's like their own Cameron Highland, but bigger and nicer and cleaner.
就好像我们的那个金马仑高原这样子，只不过说嘛，比金马仑还要大，干净，然后更漂亮。
So here's some of the pictures of waterfall.
这边有个瀑布。
Okay, so beautiful. And then you know this, because it's up in the mountain, it's cold enough. They actually have a lot of farm, cattle farm, sheep farm, and it's kind of like a European town there.
然后因为它是一个高原地区，然后天气很冷，所以他们那边可以有很多那个农场，那些农场是饲养那一些绵羊啊。
Yeah, you can see a lot of wildlife. You know, sometimes you can even see wild elephants.
然后你可以看到很多野生动物，有时还可以看到什么野生的像大象。
So I think sometimes you're on Facebook or YouTube, right? You see those elephants that are what called sitting on the car, rushing to the car. You seen those? Okay, some of it was taken from this area, you know, Khao Yai.
如果你在 YouTube 那边是吗？看到有些视频是讲，就是说，大象是吗？骑上那一个车那边的话是吗？然后这一些视频是在这一个 Khao Yai 这个地方拍摄的。
Yeah, and of course, they had a baptism. So this lady was baptized. She's the wife of this man.
然后这位姐妹呢受洗了，然后她是这位弟兄的太太。
Okay, it's a very interesting story. She came went to Bangkok to work when, you know, like about 10 years ago, and he was so in love with her. She's from there, from Manila. He went all the way to Manila to find her, you know.
Bangkok.
No, Manila, Bangkok.
然后这个很有趣的那个爱情故事，然后这个姐妹是吗？在大概10年前的时候去泰国那边啊工作，然后这个弟兄是吗？是马尼拉啊菲律宾人这样，然后特地是吗？啊，因为很喜欢很喜欢这个姐妹，特地跑到曼谷那边去追她。So
he became a Christian first, and then later on his sister also came to Bangkok Church, also got baptized there. And then after many, many years of persuading, persevering, the wife got baptized at the retreat.
Wow. 然后这位菲律宾弟兄呢，首先是嘛，成为基督徒受洗了，然后没多久，他的妹妹是嘛，也来到曼谷也受洗了，然后经过很多年的那个坚持，不断的说服他太太，然后他太太终于受洗了。
Okay, so, amen. Are we ready for a lesson?
Yes.
Alright, so today we're going to continue our prayer series. Wrestling in prayer. Wrestling in prayer. Okay, let's open our Bible app. Come on. Let me see your handphone. And put on airplane mode. Huh?
记得把你的手机放进那个静音
or your Bible or your paper Bible. Okay, let's open it up. Okay, and let's prepare. Okay, our mind. Let's take down notes. We want to be a church, right, brothers and sisters, who are devoted to prayer.
然后来，那我们做好准备，就是摘下那个要点，因为我们要我们的教会成为一个对祷告。 特别热忱，特别敬虔的教会。
Prayer is such an important aspect of our life as a Christian.
然后祷告是基督生命里面很重要的一个环节。
Okay, but you find that prayer, you know, it's sometimes a very difficult aspect of our life.
然后同时，祷告在我们的生活当中，生活也是很难，或者是很有挑战性。
So if you remember, okay, the last few times we talk about prayer, we talk about three topics. The first one was about the passion of prayer.
如果还记得上几次我们谈到这个祷告系列的话，是吗？我们曾经谈过就是祷告的热忱。
In our heart, there's a passion, there's a hunger to pray.
然后在我们心里面，是吗？我们有一个渴望，有一个热忱，想要祷告。
Okay, and then secondly, we talk about the prayer of a devoted heart. God wants to answer our prayer, not because we are so awesome, but because what we are devoted to a relationship with him.
然后我们也谈到就是一个很敬虔的心的祷告，然后神愿意去应许我们的祷告，还是聆听我们的祷告是吗？是因为我们愿意奉出我们的全部是吗？去专心的经营这一段关系。
Again, God is our friend, and that's why He wants to answer your prayer. Because he is your devoted friend.
然后神是我们的朋友，他是我们最亲近、亲密的朋友，所以他愿意回应还是应许我们祷告。Okay,
then we talk about how in prayer we don't just go ask for requests, but we need to have a heart of thanksgiving and praise towards God.
然后同时我们也谈到，就是在我们的祷告里面说啊，我们不只是 向神要求，向神提出我们需要而已，而是当我们向神祷告的时候，我们要有一个感恩，还有称赞颂神的心。Okay,
so today we're going to talk about what? Wrestling in prayer. Let's turn our Bible to the book of Colossians, chapter 4, verse 12.
今天我们就谈到就是祷告中里面的那个争斗，然后我们去到哥罗西书1:12。 有你们那里的人做基督耶稣仆人的以巴弗，问你们安。他在祷告之间，常为你们竭力的祈求，愿你们在上帝一切的旨意上得以完全，信心充足，能站立得稳。
So here is a very interesting passage, you know. And it talks about a brother called Epaphras. And the Bible says what? He was wrestling in prayer for the church in Colossae.
然后这一边上啊，有个有趣的那个故事，他讲到一个弟兄叫以巴弗的，然后他为了那教会上啊，竭力，尽力的在那边祷告祈求。
Have you ever thought about the thought of, you know, wrestling in prayer? I didn't know prayer also is a wrestling.
然后你曾经有没有幻想过，还是想过，就是说，其实你的祷告是吗，也是可以一种竭力的斗争。
A lot of times we just think about prayer very somber, very solemn, very quiet. You know, we always have this kind of worshipful kind of mentality about prayer.
然后我们通常说对祷告的概念是嘛，就是很圣洁，然后可能很安静，很庄重的。You
know, but the Bible says here there's an aspect of prayer. It's a wrestling, you know.
然后可是圣经里面这边却提到，就是说有另外一种祷告，然后这种祷告的话，就是啊，竭力的那个斗争。Okay,
you've seen wrestling matches before, right? Two big guys coming together, you know, facing each other. And they fight in the ring, and they wrestle in the ring, and they push, they headlock, and they, you know, it's very intense. You see wrestling matches, right?
然后你有看过那个摔跤比赛吗？你有看到两个魁梧的那个大汉是吗？在那边啊，互相的那个挣扎，然后互相的角力啊，这样。
Okay, so the Bible says that in our prayer, we also need to learn to what? Wrestle, you know, in our prayer.
所以圣经里面这边教导我们，就是在我们的祷告当中是吗？我们也要像那些摔跤手这么样的去啊斗争。So
that means that it takes effort, it takes strength, it takes determination, it has a fight in your prayer.
这也意味着就是说，你的祷告是吗？是需要有心机的，然后是需要有力量的，然后是需要有。 坚定的那一个意志力的。
You know, prayer is not just God, I love you, you're wonderful, thank you. You know, please pray, please answer my prayer. You know, I have this request. That's a wrestle, you know, Bible says. Again, if Patras was wrestling in his prayer, that's intensity, that's work, that's energy that goes in our prayer.
然后, 祷告并不单单只是像这样，就是说，神啊，感谢你啊，我爱你啊，请你应许我要祷告这样的。可是祷告说完也可以像这以巴弗这么样，就是是很有集中力的，然后很有力量的，然后是需要竭尽全力的去那边争斗争的。
Okay, it's no wonder someone like Epaphras, he doesn't fall asleep in his prayer.
所以难怪圣王以巴弗在他祷告的时候，圣王是绝对不打瞌睡的。Right?
How to fall asleep when you're wrestling?
你在摔跤的时候，你怎么样可以是睡觉呢
？Right? Many of us when we pray early in the morning or late at night, we are like Heavenly Father, help me to keep my eyes open.
然后我们当头圣王，很多人圣王在一大清早还是夜晚的时候圣王祷告的时候圣王，我们在那边打瞌睡的。 我讲啊，神啊，请你保守着我，保守我眼睛睁开一下。You
know, so you go ask yourself, do you ever thought about this aspect? Do you wrestle in prayer?
所以我们有没有想到这一点呢？就是我们在我们的祷告里面是吧，是竭力的那一个斗争的。
Are we even familiar what it means to wrestle in prayer?
然后我们是否熟悉怎么样的去在祷告里面斗争
？So let's look at what does it mean, okay, to wrestle in prayer.
然后我们来看看什么啊，祷告里面的斗争是什么意思
？So we're gonna look at a guy. His name is Jacob, and the Bible talks about how Jacob wrestled with God in prayer. Let's turn to Genesis, book of Genesis. We're gonna read chapter 32, verse 22 to verse 30.
然后我们讲一下创世纪里面看雅各，然后看看雅各怎么样的神是吧，角力斗争。第二十二节，他夜间起来，带着两个妻子，两个使女。 并十一个儿子都过了亚伯渡口 先打发他们过河，又打发所有的都过去，只剩下雅各一人。有一个人来跟他摔跤，直到黎明。那人见自己胜过他，就将他的大腿窝摸了一把。雅各的大腿窝正在摔跤的时候就扭了。那人说：“天黎明了，容我去吧。”雅各说：“你不给我祝福，我就不容你去。”那人说：“你名叫什么？”他说：“我名叫雅各。”那人说：“你的名不要再叫雅各，要叫以色列，因为你与上帝的你与上帝与人较力，都得胜了。”雅各问他说：“请将你的名告诉我。”那人说：“何必问我的名？”于是在那里给雅各祝福，雅各便给那地方起名叫比努伊勒，意思是说我面对面见了上帝，我的命仍然保全。日头刚出来的时候，雅各经过比努伊勒，他的大腿就瘸了，故此以色列人不吃大腿锅的筋，直到那今日，因为那人摸了雅各大腿锅的筋。
So here's a passage that talks about how Jacob wrestled with God face to face.
那这篇故事呢，就讲到雅各怎么样面对面的与神角力。
So the background of this passage is Jacob, you know Jacob, right? He was about to meet his elder brother, his twin brother Esau.
然后这个故事的背景呢，就是雅各啊，即将要就是啊面见他的那一个孪生兄弟啊以索。
Okay, and Jacob was actually very afraid to meet his brother Esau.
然后其实雅各是非常怕他的，怕见到他的哥哥以索的。
Okay, the reason is because what? In the early days when Jacob was young, when he lived with Esau, Jacob always tricked his brother and bully his brother Esau.
因为他们小时候，当他们还在住在一起的时候，是吗？雅各时常都骗他的哥哥，欺负他的哥哥。
Okay, there was a time where Esau was so hungry, right? And he wanted to have a bowl of soup. Jacob tricked him, you know. Say, here, I give you soup, but you give me your birthright.
然后有一次呢，以索啊，他觉得很饿，然后那个时候呢，雅各就利用这个机会是吗，去啊戏弄他，去欺负他。然后那个时候以索想要喝一碗热汤，然后雅各是准备了热汤，可是条件呢就是啊，你要把你的那个长子的那个权利特权是吗给我。
Again, you know, by birthright, right? That means, you know, it's supposed to be the eldest brother who's going to inherit everything first. Again, but when Jacob has the birthright, that means Jacob will be the first one to inherit, the inheritance from the father.
然后这个长子的特权呢，基本上就是说，你有这一个权利，你有这一个地位是吗？是可以继承你父亲的所有的那一些遗产一样。然后当雅各得到了，通常长子只有这个特权的。然后当雅各得到这一个所谓长子的特权的时候，也意味着他有继承他父亲所有财产、所有遗产的那一个权利。
So can you imagine losing your birthright to your other brother?
然后你可以想象一下吗？就是说当你失去了这一个长子的继承权给你的弟弟。
Wow, that means if Jacob wanted everything from the home, he could have taken it all.
那也意味着就是说，当雅各什么想要占有整间屋子全部的东西的话，什么他有权利去拿完全部的。
And not only that, okay, there was another time where the father knew about Jacob's trickery. He decided to try to trick Jacob, you know. Okay, and he said, I'm going to bless my son, he told his wife. Please bring Esau here so that I can bless Esau instead of Jacob.
然后不单单是这样，还有一次是吗？就是他父亲也被骗了。 然后他的父亲虽然知道就是这个雅阁虽然有狡猾的，然后他已经知道就是说伊索的那个长子的权力虽然已经被他骗走了，所以他有一次就跟他太太说 OK 我要啊赐下我的祝福给我的长子伊索，然后叫他太太把他的那长子算叫进来。
Again, but Jacob and the mother were very clever, you know. And they decided to disguise themselves like Esau. Esau very hairy, right? I'm going to disguise myself like Esau. And still, the father's blessing!
然后可是呢，他的妈妈还有雅各是吗？非常聪明。然后他们决定的是假扮以索，然后啊，以索是吗？啊，身上长了很多那种毛，然后他就披上那一个毛是吗？假扮以索来偷掉他父亲的那一个祝福。
So if you're Esau, can you imagine how you're feeling towards your brother Jacob? Stole your birthright. Not only that, now stole all the blessing.How you feel? You be so angry towards your brother, Jacob.
所以想象一下，如果你是以索的话，是吗？你会有什么感受？这一个弟弟是吗？不单单只是偷掉了你的那一个长子的继承权，同时也偷掉了他父亲是吗给他的祝福，你肯定是很生气的。
And so because Jacob was so afraid, actually the mother was afraid, not Jacob. Again, the mother sent Jacob far away, to live with the uncle.
然后因为雅各的妈妈是吗觉得很害怕，所以他就决定把雅各是吗送到他舅舅家很远的地方。
So finally, Jacob again, grown up, got married, and decided to go back to his home country.
然后最后呢，雅各长大了，同时也结婚了，然后他也决定就是说要回到他的那个家乡。
然后balik kampung, but to balik kampung.Must be who? His brother Esau.
可是呢，要回老家的话，是吗？就得要面对他的哥哥伊索。
Okay, so he knows, you know, I'm gonna when I go home, even though he didn't want to go to the same place, right? He was planning to go to another town. My brother Esau is gonna come and find me.
然后他知道，就是当他回去的时候，是吗？他会遇到伊索。然后哪怕他是准备是吗？回到另外一个小镇的。不是回到他的老家那边去是吧？可是他也知道以索是吗？会去那个小镇那边找他。
And when Esau heard that Jacob was coming home, he came with his whole army, with all his gangs, to meet up with Jacob. So can you imagine how Jacob was feeling? Esau and his gang is meeting me.
然后当以索知道是吗？雅各回来说是吗？他就带了他的那一个整队军队是吗？来半路在那边迎接他。
And so, that night, before meeting Esau, if you read earlier in chapter 32, you know, Jacob prayed to God, God, please save me. I am too afraid to meet Esau.
然后这个故事呢，就发生在就是他面对以索之前的那个晚上。那个晚上后，他向神祷告，就是神，他就祷告说，神，我很害怕面对以索，请你救救我。
And that night, God came to meet Jacob.
然后那一晚上神来见了雅各。
And Jacob wrestled with God the whole night.
然后雅各是吗？就和神一整晚的在那边摔跤。
So what's the first point? What does it mean to wrestle with God? It means what? You're gonna pray until you what? Overcome.Where Jacob says, God, I'm not going to let you go until what? You bless me.
那和神摔一跤一整晚的意思是什么呢？也就是说，我们要祷告到就是说我们克服了，我们超越了，就好像雅各和那一个人摔跤，神摔跤，直到就是说那一个人愿意祝福我。
Okay, that's what the first word say here, right? They were praying. Jacob prayed, you know, God, I'm not going to let you go until you give me what I want.
然后这边就是雅各说了，就是说我绝对不会放过你的，放走你的，除非你给我所想要的。
You know, so he was wrestling, you know. God wanted to leave already. He said, hey, they break already, I'm a child. Not like God is a vampire or anything, have a child. Because I want a child anyway. But, you know, Jacob was so scared, right? Of his brother Esau. He wanted to make sure God is going to protect him.
然后神其实到天亮的时候，圣马就开始要走了，不是因为说神好像细节像是鬼这样怕太见太阳，只不过他觉得时间够了要走了。可是雅各却不愿意放过这个神，因为他对于他的哥哥太害怕了，他希望神圣马来又祝福他，以便给他那个力量，圣马去面对他哥哥。
You know, you gotta ask yourself when you pray, do you wrestle with God? Are you like Jacob? You're gonna fight with God until what you get what you want. You're blessed.
然后没有我们自己，就是当我们祷告的时候，是吗？我们是否有好像雅各这一种斗争、这一种角力的那个态度啊？直到我们克服了，直到我们得到神的那个祝福。
Again, you don't give up easily. You know, you really fight with God. You wrestle. You know.
你不能轻易放弃的。 然后你真的是和神是吗？在那角力。
Many of us, right? You pray, and then what? You pray, and then third day you pray, and then no answer. Fourth day you forget.
然后我们当中很多人是吗？就是我们祷告三天了，然后看到那个祷告没有被应许，第四天就忘记了。
Okay, or I ask you today, bro, what did you pray yesterday? Not sure.
又或者我问你，就是说，哎，你弟兄，你今天说啊，为了什么祷告啊，祷告了些什么这样？然后你可能会讲，我不知道。
If that's your prayer, are you really wrestling? If you wrestle, you want to win, you know.
如果你的祷告是这样的话，是吗？你再问问你自己，你是否真正的好像在那边斗争着？因为如果你真的想要角力，真的要斗争的话，是吗？你很想要赢的。
In order to wrestle, it takes that heart of determination, that resilience, that persevering, that momentum. You know, you will remember when you pray, and you pray for a long time about the same thing. You don't give up.
然后，如果你是有这个斗争的那个心的话，是吗？你的那个祷告上就会带有那个坚持，带有那个力量，带有那个抵抗力这样。 所以，当你有这一种祷告的时候，你可以祷告很久很久很久，然后风湿的时候，你不会忘记你所祷告的东西的。Okay,
I remember my own life. I shared with you before, right? About my dating life, my wife, my girlfriend back then, and I was a very quiet guy, and not sensitive to a feeling. Have I shared with you that? I have, right?
然后我曾经跟你分享过，就是说我拍拖，约会的那种生活吗？就是说，我太太当时我的女朋友是吗？ 我有分享过，就是说那个时候我对所感受的嘛，并不是那么一样的那么敏感，那么样的细腻的。Okay,
and you know, because I was so insensitive, so quiet. You know, when she talk, I'm really quiet. Okay, and she was fed up with me. You know, she wanted to break up with me.
因为那个时候是嘛，我不是很敏感，然后我也不是很体贴这样，所以当她不断的那边讲的时候是嘛，我还是很静的。 然后他最后说完，对我就是觉得很失望，然后甚至他想要分手这样。
Now she didn't tell me. In fact, she was so heartbroken that I was so insensitive. She told my disciple. My disciple told me, take me, you don't repent of your insensitivity. Patrice, we were in Singapore at that time. She's going to go back to America. Oh, yeah.
然后你知道他失望到什么，不直接跟我讲。 他是跟我的那个辅导人讲，然后结果我的辅导人说啊，告诉我就说，哎，对，如果说啊你不悔改的话，不改过你的那个缺乏敏感的，不关心的，不体贴的那个态度的话，说啊，有一天你的太太说啊，不去生完就会回去美国了。
You know, I was so desperate to change my quietness, desperate to change my mouth. I don't want to lose Patrice. I was so desperate. I really wrestled. I prayed super hard the next few months. God help me to change. And God help me to be a talkative brother. God help me not to be quiet anymore. Quiet is not wisdom. Silent is not golden for technique. Silent is losing my girlfriend, Patrice.
然后那时候我就很紧张，然后我很不愿意就是失去那个失去 Patrice， 所以那个时候是吧，我就在我的祷告里面是吧，是有这个斗争，有这个角力的，然后我向神祈求，就是说帮助我啊，帮助我变成一个击杀的人，帮助我是吧啊，能够张开我的口腔啊，因为沉默不再是金啊，然后沉默不再智慧，沉默会让我失去 Patrice。
Okay, I told God, I'm not gonna let go, you know, God, until you change my character.
那我告诉神就是说啊，我不会放弃的啊，直到你改变我的那性格。
You know, and that's how I change. Okay, if you compare me now versus me when I was younger, it's like 1,000 times difference. 1,000, not 10 times, 1,000 times.
然后也就是因为那时候有改变的，如果你那我现在跟我年轻的时候比的话是吧我的改变生活是千倍来算的。
Okay, if you can find a brother that's really quiet, right, or a person that's really quiet in your job place, I'm exactly like that. Very quiet. I will only speak when I need to speak. And
then 然后如果你在你的工作上面是吧看到一个很近的那个同事的话是吧然后我就像你那个同事这样然后我只是会在有必要有需要的时候是吧才会开口讲话的。
You know, so how did I change? It's not because I'm so awesome, I have all this skill, I'm so powerful, I can change my mouth. It's because what? God wrestle until God changed my heart, He changed my character, you know, to help me to be a sensitive brother.To help me to learn to talk to my girlfriend, now my wife.
然后不是因为就是说我很有天分，还是我很厉害这样，还是我有很多那个技巧能够改变我自己这样而是我不断的接力斗争、接力奋斗，要求神是吧改变我的那个个性，改变我就是说不体贴不愿意讲话的那个个性。然后直到我改变过来赢得了我的女朋友，现在我的太太。
Okay, brothers, sisters, do you pray? Do you wrestle in your prayer until God bless you?
所以弟兄姐妹们，在我们祷告里面上，我们是否有和神有这一些斗争呢？然后直到神祝福我们。
Okay, of course, it doesn't mean God will 100% answer everything. There's certain times when He will hold back, like what I always talk about.
那当然神并不一定就是说每一次都100%这么应许我们的那个祷告，然后有时候是吧，就像我所形容的，就他会保留住他的那一个应许。
Okay, but you're gonna pray non-stop until you see what is the answer.
是的，我们还是要不停不止的那一个祷告，然后直到什么神祝福我们。
Okay, I think about King David.You know, King David, if you read the Bible, he committed adultery, right? And then God decided to what? To punish him, and the son that's born out of adultery, wedlock. You know, what God will die.
然后这让我想到了就是大卫王这样。然后如果你记得的话，是吧？大卫王犯了那个奸淫罪这样，所以神就决定要惩罚他的。孩子，然后同时他因为奸淫关系而生的那个第一个孩子是吗？也会被处死。
But the Bible says that David wrestled in prayer with God. He didn't eat, he didn't drink, he prayed, he fasted. You know, the next few days or weeks, okay, and pray to God. God, please spare this child. Let him live the physical life. You know, he pray nonstop.You wrestle with God.
然后这个时候呢，大卫王是吧，就不断的在那边祷告，不停的在那边向神跟神斗争，跟神那个祷告这样。然后他为了他的孩子能够继续活下去嘛，不吃不喝，不停的祷告，同时也进食这样。
Okay, but of course, in that case, God decided not to answer David's prayer. The child passed away, and of course, we know the child is in heaven. All right.Better place for the child, but God decided to help to what God to discipline David through that activity to help him not that activity that situation to help David to see the error of his life.
然后在这情况下呢，神呢就保留他的应许，然后绝对不会应许他的。然后那个孩子他最后是死了，然后现在这个孩子的时候他就在天堂一个更好的地方。然后神有时是像这个情况下是为了要教训大卫王所犯下的错是吗？而不是应许他们的。
Okay, but David never stopped praying until the answers was given. Until there was an answer.
然后可是呢这个过程当中是吗？大卫没有停止过他的祷告，然后直到他得到那个答案为止。
You know, so brothers, do you have that intensity? You know, we've been talking about what? Grow, change your habits, bad habits. Do you have that intensity to change your bad habits, your character weaknesses that you know you need to change?
弟兄姐妹们，我们是否有那一个激情，有那一个集中力呢？然后我们一直在那边讨论我们一直在那边祷告，还是一直教导我们这怎么样去改变，怎么样去成长？我们是否有那一个集中力，还有那一个激情，是吧？去为自己祷告呢？
Okay, and sometimes you wonder how come I'm not changing? Oh, I want to change, but I'm still the same old guy. The question you gotta ask yourself: Are you wrestling in prayer with God? Do you have the same attitude, Jacob?God, I'm not going to let you go until you bless me.
有时你可能在那边埋怨，在那边想着，为什么我还没有改变呢？然后你可能你就要问你自己，就是说你在祷告当中是吗？你是否与神有过摔跤，有过斗争呢？就好像雅各这样，他和神摔跤斗争，直到神祝福他为止。
You know, brothers and sisters, again, I want us.As a church, as disciples, to really be deep, to really be devoted in our prayer. When we pray, we really wrestle with God.
然后弟兄姐妹们，我真的希望就是说，我们作为基督徒，作为一个教会圣啊，对祷告圣啊是敬虔的，然后同时对祷告圣啊是深入的，然后在祷告当中圣啊，我们有这一种斗争的。
Okay, what else does it mean? To wrestle with God, to struggle with God and man and overcome.
然后这还意味着什么呢？就是和神和人斗争，直到克服为止。
Okay, so in this passage, the Bible says what? God changed Jacob's name to Israel. And the meaning of Israel is what? He struggled with God and man and overcome.
然后这些经文里面提到，就是说雅各的名字改了，变成以色列。然后因为以色列的意思就是说，你已经与神交力得了胜。
What does that mean? You know, why did God change his name and said you have struggled with God and not just struggle with God and with men and finally you've overcome?
然后这是什么意思呢？就是说神替你改一个名字，然后同时你的名字的意思就是你已经和神角力了，然后同时你已经得胜了。
Most of us, right, will think, wow, that what it means, that he overcame, he fought with God. He told God, I'm not gonna let you go until you bless me. And he won. God submitted to him.
然后我们可能是嘛，有这一个错觉，就是说，哇，他与神斗争了，然后他斗争到神愿意祝福他为止，也就是说他赢过神了。
Okay, it's like he's standing on God. God, hey, do what I say, submit, I win already. That's what we think, right?
就好像我们认为就是说我们打败神了，把神踩在脚下这样，所以说神啊，你要服从我啊这样。
Okay, it doesn't mean that. It's the other way.
然后这不是他的意思，而相反的才是真正的意义。
All right, if you notice, who approached Jacob?
然后如果你注意的话，是吗？是谁是吗？先去接触雅各的。
Okay, Jacob prayed earlier in the day, save me. But guess what? In the night, who approached Jacob?God approached Jacob.
然后雅各呢，就在一大早白天的时候是吗？ 向神祷告，希望神能够救他。然后到晚上的时候呢，神却主动解除他。
Okay, who was winning the fight? It's not Jacob, you know. God was actually winning the fight. God just didn't want to crush him.
然后到头来，谁真正是赢了这个角力呢？其实是神，神赢了角力，然后只是神不愿意去就是说祭拜还是免罪他而已。
Okay, how do I know? The Bible says that God just touched Jacob's hip. Hey, my God, break already. If God wanted to go, no problem. Touch this hip, touch it, that hip. Okay, more powerful than Chinese kung fu, you know. Jacob cannot even walk, paralyzed.
我怎么知道呢？因为什么？经文里面讲到的就是说神是吗？碰到了大腿骨，然后大腿骨就断了。然后如果神真的很想赢的话，是吗？他其实在碰另外大腿骨上，这样那个两个人就根本不用想把他打了。
So what does it mean? Jacob struggled with God, again, and he overcome.
然后这意味着什么呢？也就是说，雅各与神角力，然后最后他克服了，他得胜了。
Alright, we're going to look at how Jacob was like in the early days of his life and versus that present situation.
那我们呢，现在做的比较，就是说雅各早年的那个日子，还有现在，就是说角力过后那个日子，他的人变成什么样
？Okay, let's go to chapter 28.And we're going to read verse 20 to 22.
然后我们去到第创世纪第28章20到22节。雅各许愿说：“上帝若与我同在，在我所行的路上保佑我，又给我食物吃，衣服穿，使我平平安安的回到我父亲的家，我就必以耶和华为我的上帝，我所立。”为柱子的石头也必做上帝的殿，凡你赐给我的，我必将十分之一献给你。
You know, here's the passage, the situation where actually Jacob in the night had a dream. God visited him through a ladder. They call it Jacob's ladder.
然后这个时候呢，基本上是形容雅各在梦里面，他梦见神了，然后神说他是从一个那个楼梯里面下来。
Jacob was at this point running away, leaving town, right? Running away from his brother Esau after he tricked his brother Esau.
然后这个时候呢，雅各其实是在在骗了他的那个哥哥过后，是吗？逃离他哥哥。
You would think, after meeting God, Jacob will be so humble.
你可能会认为是吗？当雅各见了神过后，是吗？他应该是非常谦卑。
Right? Can you imagine if God spent time with you, He sit down with you, all His glory, flame, fire, and He had a chat with you? What would you do? You say, right?
你可以想象一下，就是说，哇，当你看到神的话，是吗？他散发的那个光芒的话，是吗？他和你交谈这样。
But look at Jacob, his audacity, his pride. You know, if God will do this for me, then The Lord will be my Lord, my God. He still can bargain with God.
然后你看他有多骄傲，可是然后雅各就说，如果你是吗赐福于我这些东西的话，是吗？我才以耶和华为我的神。跟他讨价还价。
Right? If God, this is God, real or not? If God really answer my prayer, then I will believe Him.
然后他那时候他就想，这个神说到底是真的还是假的？这样，如果神能够应许我祷告的话，是吧？我才相信这个神是真的。
It's my early days attitude before I became a Christian. Yeah, God show me lah. Okay, you appear, then I'll believe. I was totally arrogant.
就好像早期的我，然后在那边成为基督徒的，这样，神啊，如果你是真的话，是吧？你写信给我看呐，这样我就相信了。然后当时的我是非常骄傲。
Okay, I didn't want to believe, I didn't want to follow, because my heart, very proud, very self-sufficient.
然后啊，我那时候什么不愿意相信，也不愿意跟追随这样，因为那时候我心里面非常骄傲，我觉得我是很知足的。
Because I feel I can do it, I can do it myself. I don't need who is this God.
那那时候会觉得就是说，哎，我可以做到的，我可以自己一个人做到的。然后这个神是谁啊
？And if I know this God, will He really help me?
那如果我真的认识这个神的话，说啊。他真的会帮我吗？
啊、my mother say, you know what? God won't bring money from heaven, you know. Did your mother tell you that?
那我妈妈告诉我，就是说啊，神是不会再从天堂上面撒钱下来的。
So funny, you know. My father wanted wanted to be a Christian. He said, "Hey, your God is not going to rain money on to you. Why you have to go to church, believe?"
然后我的父母是蛮搞笑的，就是说他们很担心我为什么会基督徒，所以他们告诉我就说啊，你为什么信教会呢？你的神是吗？是不会在天上撒钱给你的。
You know, my attitude really, really arrogant, self-sufficient.
那我那一个啊、时候是吗？啊、是非常非常的骄傲，非常非常的自负。
Okay, that's just how Jacob was like. Hey, God, really, God? Are you sure, God? Really? Then I do what you say.
然后跟雅各一样，就是说啊、他会质疑啊、神是真的吗？如果是真的话，是吗？啊、你应许我先呢，然后我才相信。
Okay, but you notice that chapter 32, his attitude totally radically changed. You read verse 9 and 10.
然后我们去到第32章的时候。你就发现到他的那个啊、态度上做了180度的改变。我们去到第九节，雅各说：“耶和华，我主亚伯拉罕的上帝，我父亲以撒的上帝啊，你曾对我说，回你本族去，我要厚待你。你向仆人所施的一切慈爱和诚实，我一点也不配得。我先前只拿着我的杖过这约旦河。”如今我却成了两队人。
Okay, look at the attitude, totally different. Earlier, if God, then, now, I am unworthy. I am totally unworthy of you, God. You are so awesome.
哎，看他的态度是吗？做了180度的改变。之前呢，就是说，如果神你做重要的话，然后我才怎么这样。然后现在是吗？他却说我不配得的。
I need you, God. I'm not worthy of your grace. I'm not worthy of your help. Save me.
然后他说我不配得你的那一个慈爱，不配得你的那一个啊、保守这样。所以啊、请你救我吧。
Okay, and you read the next two verse 11 and verse 12.
然后我们看第十一节，求你救我脱离我哥哥以所的。手，因为我怕他来杀我，连妻子带儿女一同杀了。你曾说，我必定厚待你，使你的后裔如同海边的沙，多得不可胜数。
You know, here totally different. Save me, God, I'm afraid. Wow, like his self confidence all gone.
然后这边说啊，你可以看到了，就是说他向神祈求说啊，请你拯救我啊，啊，然后他之前的那个骄傲，之前的那个自信，什么完全一扫而空。
Right before he was so arrogant towards his brother Esau, he tricked his brother Esau, stole the birthright, you know, and even tricked the father, you know. He talking about brother, yeah, sibling rivalry, but even the father, he really tricked the father. My goodness, so arrogant.
然后之前的他说完是多么的骄傲，他骄傲到就是说他欺骗了他的哥哥，欺骗了爸爸，啊，偷掉他的哥哥那一个长子那个特权这样，然后偷掉他父亲是吧？给他啊大哥的那个祝福这样，是多么的骄傲。
But now he was broken. He was a man without courage about himself.
然后啊、现在呢，他却彻底的那一个。崩溃了，粉碎了，然后他是非常的害怕。
His courage comes from God.
然后这个时候他的那一个勇气是从神而来的。
And isn't that what happened to Moses as well?
然后你没想到这也是发生在摩西的身上一样的。
Remember Moses? Again, when he was young, a young prince, he went out to what? I'm going to free the Israelite. And he killed one of the Egyptian soldiers. I'm going to let you be free.
然后当摩西还年轻的时候，当他还是王子的时候，是吗？他为了那以色列人，是吗？去斗争，然后他想要解放那些以色列人，所以他意外的杀死一个那一个埃及人。
Okay, but 40 years later, after living in the wilderness, you know, when God met him at the burning bush, Moses was like, "Don't send me, I cannot do it." Totally changed, you know. He was broken and humble.
可是呢，然后当他在旷野里面、沙漠里面活了四十年之后，是吧？直到见到那个神的火之后，是吧？然后他完全改变了，然后他告诉神就说我很害怕，不要选我。
Okay, so exactly, what does it mean to wrestle with God in prayer? It's to learn to be broken before God.
然后第二点呢，就是要怎么样才算是与神斗争呢？也就是在神的面前，是吧？谦卑，然后谦卑。
Okay, and when you're so broken before God, when you are so humble before God, then you find that you will actually learn to trust and obey God.
然后当你是吧，在神的面前谦卑的时候，是吧？你才会学习到怎么样去相信，然后服从、遵从神。
So what did he overcome? He overcame his heart, you know. That's what he overcame. He overcame his heart, his arrogant heart, his prideful heart.
然后最后他胜了什么呢？他克服了什么呢？他最后是胜了他自己骄傲、自负的心。
You know, brothers and sisters, again, you can ask yourself, are you wrestling with God about your heart? God, help me to be humble. Help me to trust your ways. Help me to submit to your will.
然后弟兄姐妹们，我们是否有为我们的心中呢而与神斗争呢？与神角力呢？然后我们是否有在祷告里面祈求神，就是帮助我谦卑下来，帮助我相信神，帮助我去遵从你的意愿？
Because it is not easy to submit to God's will. Not easy at all.
然后因为去遵从神的意愿的话，是吗？是不简单的，是很难的。
Right, even for Jesus, what not easy? Garden of Gethsemane, what was his prayer? God, I don't want to drink this cup.
然后哪怕是耶稣的话，是吗？他在哥西马利的时候，是吗？哥西马利祷告的时候，是吗？他也曾经跟神那边祈求，就说我不想要喝下这一杯的。
Okay, the human side of Jesus, the divine side of Jesus, say yes. But the human side of Jesus, like us, human, cannot. The pain, the suffering, no way, God, please take this cup away from me. Yet not as my will, but your will be done.
所以呢，耶稣就是属灵的那一面，神圣那一面，是吗？是说，是你应该遵从神的意愿，可是。人性，耶稣人性的那一面是却说，却告诉他，就说这太难了，这太痛苦了，我没有办法承受了。如果可以的话，是吧？请你把这一杯，是吧？从我生命里面带走。可是如果这个不是如果这个是你的意愿的话，是吧？我却选择服从。
Okay, it's not easy. It's not easy to submit to God's will. But are you wrestling with your heart in prayer?Are you asking with God? Are you struggling with God to learn to what? To trust and obey.
然后要服从神的意愿，是吗？是不简单的。可是，在我们祷告当中，是吗？我们是否有和神角力，有和神斗争呢？然后在这斗争过程中，我们学会了相信神，学会了遵从神的意愿。
Okay, here's some examples.Are you wrestling with God to be a Christian student? Or are you a worldly student?
然后这边就是一些例子，就说我们是否与神有角力，成为一个属神基督的学生，还是一个世俗的学生。
Okay, think about what's the difference, a Christian student versus a worldly student. What's the difference?
然后想想就是说一个作为基督的学生和属世学生是吗？有什么分别？
Now, a worldly student is a personal gain. I want to do well because I want to glorify myself. Make a lot of money myself one day.
然后属世的学生是吗？的出发点是为了自己的利益。然后我想他的意愿可能就是说我想要就是在学业里面是吗？做好是为了我个人的荣耀，然后将来我会赚大钱。
Okay, Christian student, I want to do well because I want to glorify God. I want people to see me and say, "Wow, God is so awesome. Your life changed because you have a God."
可是呢，基督的学生是吗？却是为了要荣耀神是吗？而去尽力的努力学习这样，然后他希望就是说。他作为一个榜样，当人家看到他的时候，可以看到神怎么样在一个学生的身上是吧，动工改变他的人生。
So do you wrestle with God in prayer? Because it's hard. You know why it's hard? You have a lot of friends that were very worldly, indisciplined, lazy, want to do a lot of naughty things, temptation. A lot of them surround you and say,do with us. Ayya, why you so RJ? You know RJ, religious joke. Why always bring Bible? Then you're why?
然后这是很难的。你知道为什么很难吗？因为你身边什么有很多那个属世的那个学生，属世的学生会怎么跟你讲呢？就是说。哎呀，你为什么这么虔诚呀？哎呀，这些学生是吧，不断在那影响你。他们有一些是吧，可能是没有纪律、懒惰顽皮这样，然后有一些坏习惯这样。他们不断的是吧，这边说服你说，哎，来啦，跟我们一起啦，来啦，我们一起玩这东西啦，还是我们一起做这东西啦？那你为什么像好像一个尼姑啊？还是一个和尚样的。
Okay, it's not easy. They talk about, you know, I know, I was a student. Even now, my friends, you know what they love to joke about? Women. Okay, all kind of stuff. Wow, I tell you, so hard, you know. But do you pray? God, help me to overcome. Help me to be a Christian student.
哪怕现在也是，就是说我身边的朋友说啊，他们都很喜欢开玩笑。然后开玩笑什么呢？就是拿女人来开玩笑，然后讲一大堆是吧？关于女人的东西这样，所以在我心里面说是真的很难受的。可是我们是否为了这一个是吧，而去有和神在祷告里面是吧斗争，在祷告里面角力呢
？Okay, how about schedule? Do you trust God in your schedule? Do you wrestle? You know, we got to have a Christian schedule.
然后我们的那一个行程，我们的一个日程表又怎么样呢？然后我们是否相信神，然后愿意与神角力，特别作为一个那个基督徒的那一个时间表
？So what's a Christian schedule? Don't know. What's a Christian schedule? What's a Christian schedule?
然后基督徒的时间表是什么呢
？God, who is number one? Number one.
把神放在第一位。
Secondly, wife, number two, or husband, number two.
然后太太还是丈夫重要，作为第二。
Then thirdly, children, number three.
第三就是孩子。
Okay, after you put those three up there, then make money.
然后当你把这三个放在最高的位置过后，是吗？
Okay, make money or hobby. You know, we human beings, we like to tabale, you know. Make money or my hobby? Number one. Then children, number two. Then wife or husband, number three. Then God, last place.
然后我们人生嘛，就很喜欢把那个次序是嘛倒转。 我们的兴趣或者是赚钱是嘛排在第一位，然后第二位是嘛是我们的孩子，第三位就是我们太太还是丈夫这样。
Yeah, do we pray, wrestle with prayer that you can meet a Christian, you can have a Christian schedule? It's not easy, okay? Because people will look at you.
然后我们是否为我们的那种基督行程还是热忱表是吗？祷告，脚力呢？ 因为这是不简单的，因为身边很多人都在观察着我们。You
know, when I was working, right? Again, I worked in a construction before I was in the ministry. I was in a construction business. I tell you, they want to do a lot of overtime. They love overtime. I don't know why they love overtime. They money number one, that's why.
然后，我之前那个曾经在那个建筑公司里面工作，然后在建筑公司里面上班，他们都很喜欢上班加班。 因为他们加班能够赚更多的钱。
Okay, I remember those days. I made a commitment to God. I will never miss church. Sunday I'll be there. Friday I'll be there. And guess what? I want to study about people in the night time. Make good use of my time. 6 p.m. I say goodbye. Now once a while I do stay back because that's the urgent thing. But majority of the time, boss, I love you. I didn't say that. Boss, 6 p.m., my child. Oh, all my friends are looking at me, you know. And they're still sitting there, you know. But you know what they're doing? All doing nothing, sitting there.
然后可是那个时候是吗？我却对神做了一个承诺，就是说我会把神放在第一位。然后星期天我一定会去教会，星期五我也是一样会去教会。然后不单单是这样，就是说。 我很想跟人家继续读圣经，所以六点过后我就跟老板说，拜拜，不好意思，我要去跟他读圣经了。然后偶尔我会六点过后加班啊，当有一些紧急的事情，或者可是我尽量坚持就是六点过后是吧，把时间献给神。Okay,
it wasn't easy. I tell you the pressure of people looking at me, that was hard. You know, the fear of rejection, it was hard. But I decided I'm going to pray, I'm going to wrestle. Wrestle in prayer that I'll be a great employee, a Christian employee, who will work hard and yet dedicated to Jesus.
然后那个时候是很难的，因为很多人是吗，看到你六点走的话是吗，会对你有排斥感，然后那一种心理压力是吗，是非常沉重的。可是那个时候是吗，我就在祷告里面做呢。 就和神角力，我向神祈求，就是说我能够成为一个基督徒工人，员工在工作场合的时候是吗？能够尽力的工作，完成我自己的那一个所谓工作量，这样，然后同时也没有牺牲掉就是与神的关系还是与神的那个时间。You
know what's surprising? End of the day. Again, we were doing some construction project. When the project finished, the company wanted to close, you know. And the boss decided, okay, time to close, you have to let go of your, some of your employees, right? We are contract based, okay? He let go of everyone except me. I was the last one. And even after close, he still, he went back to Switzerland. He's from Switzerland. He said, hey, can you stay back for 6 more months? Help me in my company. Wow, Christian employee, honest, trustworthy. That's why he decided to do what he did.
Awesome. 然后很惊讶的就是，当那个建筑工程是吗完成的过后是吗，然后他会把那公司是吗关掉，那个老板是吗是一个瑞士老板这样，所以当那个建筑工程完成的时候是吗，他就裁退了是吗很多很多的人。 然后除了我，然后还不单单这样，当他回瑞士的时候是吗？他甚至叫我就是说，在这里公司待多6个月，帮他设一些首尾像。然后为什么呢？因为这就是基督徒员工的一个魅力。然后基督徒员工是吗？是可信的。 后诚实。
Okay, so here is all the other areas. There are more areas, but these are just some areas. You know, do you wrestle? The basic idea, do you wrestle with God so that what? You, your heart can stay righteous and not give in to temptation.
然后啊，这些就是以下一些例子这样。不过重点呢，就是我们是否为我们的属神的那个真理感这么脚力坚持呢？
So in closing, wrestling with God. I love this picture. That's Jacob. Wrestling.
然后总结，我很喜欢这个照片这样，这个图画这样。然后这个就是雅各。
Okay, you know who is winning? God was winning. God's on top. Jacob below.
那你知道谁赢了吗？肯定是神啊，因为神站在比较。
Okay, but that's two attitudes. Number one, you know Jacob.He's not going to let go of God. I'm not going to let go until you bless him. He has that never give up attitude.
然后雅各呢，有这一个永不放弃的那一个态度，就是说他在神祝福他之前，他绝对不会放弃。
And secondly, he wrestled with God until his heart changed. It was hard, it was painful, but his heart changed.
然后第二点就是他与神斗争，与神角力，直到他的那个心开始改变。
So, amen. So, brothers, sisters, you know, I want you to really take your prayer life one more level. You know, when you go home and pray tomorrow or tonight, really learn to wrestle with God. Really think about the areas in your life you want God to bless you with. Ask God.If God, if I put you first, help me to do this. Okay? And really wrestle with God. Amen.
所以弟兄姐妹们，今天你们回家后，我希望你们会把你的祷告生活带到另外一个高峰这样。希望你就是说，在接下来的祷告能够想清楚，就是说你想神在什么地方祝福你，然后真的脚力去祈求神帮助你改变。
Okay, so let's break up for our first time of fellowship.